1, 2, 3. Breathe out.
60, you're the baddest one. Gave you all my love that night.
What's up, YouTube? It's your girl, Silabelle, and today I'm back with another vlog for you guys. So, first of all, I feel like I haven't spoken to y'all in forever. Like, what's new? What's tea? What y'all been up to? What's going on? Your girl is currently preparing for a surgery, which is what this vlog is about to be about. Yeah, gonna be about. So yeah, today is currently September 11th, and my surgery is tomorrow, September 12th. And I just kind of wanted to take y'all along with me on like the process, preparing for it. So some of the things that I did before was I had to go get my pre-admission testing done, which I did last Wednesday. That I didn't take you guys with, I did not take you guys with me to go and do, because your girl was in a rush. Like, I had things to do. I was on a time limit. But basically, at that appointment, I got blood work twice. They did an EKG. And I spoke with the nurse. And she told me everything that I needed to know to prepare for my surgery for tomorrow. And she gave me some things that, you know, don't mind my nail. For whatever reason, it's this one nail on both hands that's just stuck. It won't come off, so I'm gonna just let it take its course, but in the meantime, just ignore it. But yeah, so here's my little goodie bag that I was given, and it basically has my instructions on how to prepare the night before, what I can and cannot take, what I can and cannot eat after certain times, yada yada yada. So speaking of that surgery, they got the nerve to have me to book my surgery at 6 a.m. Like, that's crazy. I mean, I live an hour away from the hospital where my doctor is performing the surgery, so that means I have to get up at like 4 to get myself ready, be on the road by 5 and get there by 6. And my surgery that I'm having done, my doctor said, is about 3 to 4 hours long, which I'm super nervous about, because the longest I've been under anesthesia was an hour and 45 minutes. And that was earlier this year when I got, when I had my kidney stone procedure done. So, to be under it for 3 to 4 hours, I don't know. I'm nervous. But, yeah. That's pretty much it. Your girl is going to be taking you... I'm going to be taking you guys with me tomorrow. As much as I can. I'm going to try and record as much as I can. Obviously, you guys can't come into the OR with me. But, I'm going to try to record as much as I can before everything leading up to... But yeah, you guys, say your prayers for me. Your girl is super nervous. At first, I wasn't nervous. I was aggravated because I'm like, I'm ready to get this over with. Y'all don't understand the pain I've been going through as far as my back. Everything I've been dealing with for the past 3 years. All these minor procedures I've been getting to try to minimize the pain. Nothing seems to be helping. Pain meds don't help. Muscle relaxers don't help. Oh, the only thing that really helps is the heating pad. The heating pad has been literally my best friend for the past 3 years. But yeah, other than that, nothing helps. So I'm praying to God that this surgery comes through for your girl and it helps me. I obviously, it's not going to take away all of my pain, but I'm hoping it takes away most of it, because y'all don't understand. But yeah, so I will see you guys at 4 a.m. Y'all, not my motherfucking alarm not even going off. I set my alarm for 4 o'clock. Girl, why is it 5 o'clock? Oh my gosh. Now, just what I'll be talking about. Now I'm rushing like crazy because I don't know if I mentioned last night, the freaking place is an hour away. I had to hurry up and shower again in this because you're supposed to do it the night before and the morning of. But y'all, I'm motherfucking rushing. Like, this is crazy. You can't wear no bra, no jewelry, none of that. Let me just bring this bag. Oh my gosh, oh, this is crazy. I'm gonna get to y'all in the car. I gotta go. Shout out to my nigga Reggie. Hey, Pooh, why are you not dressed yet?
Any metal on your body?
Girl, I just struggled getting him popped.
What are you doing?
I'm
like
half
here. Just woke up.
Wait, let me see if you put you.
I want you to have a good day at school today, okay?
No, not you.
Oh, him.
Look at you. Why you look confused?
Look at you going for a
long time. Guys, thank you so much. Right. So that's why his face looks like damn, like, come on, I gotta get to the hospital with your mom. But looks like they didn't even start yet.
Yeah, I'm not due to go in until 8, they said.
Oh.
But they told me that, well, my doctor said it'll be, what, 3 hours?
Yeah.
Nervous.
Are you nervous?
I don't want to tell them why.
Cause she thinks she's gonna die.
We'll be paralyzed. This is MCJ. Hi. Hi. Yeah.
My name is Alex. I'm with anesthesia.
Okay.
Very much. We'll be here longer than the surgery. Questions? I already have an IV, actually. We work as an anesthesia team with myself and Dr. Kohlmeier. A little bit later. What do you have done today?
A lumbar back surgery.
Okay. You have pain right now?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have any numbness in your legs?
It's not numbness, it's like sharp pains that shoot.
Shoot down?
Yeah.
Very good. And you had kidney surgery, it says in your chart.
Yeah. Yes.
Any problems with anesthesia?
No.
Okay. When did you eat or drink anything last time?
I ate last around 9:30.
Mm-hmm.
And then the only thing I had to drink this morning was the pre-surgery insured. Mm-hmm.
What time did you do that?
Sorry.
Yeah. Well, now mine are.
Sorry, guys.
Excellent. Have you seen Dr. Klein?
Yes.
Stay in bed.
Okay, we're good.
Okay, perfect. See you in the room that you had last night.
Okay. Yeah, so you're gonna go with the food.
So since 5 this morning, she had her insure, solids last night at 9:30. Perfect. Both consents are signed. Her back is marked on the lumbar area. She was negative on the UCG and top and screen. She was OPOS. She's got a right hand 18 gauge with LR. Agreed?
Perfect. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
That you know my heart, and you probably do. So I'm always with you. I could stay with you for hours in an empty room. Never get bored, never have nothing to do. You're my other half, you're what makes me me. What makes me smile when I fall down. I can't get back, get back, get back up.
I'm gonna do that because the kids are in the house. You should have got off at 2:30. I thought you get off at 2:30.
Shut a little bit and it will pull, help pull her. So pull yourself forward a little bit. Good. There you go. Breathe. Good. We're here. The next step is to kind of stand up. So if you want to put your hands up here or on the armrest.
It'll probably be easier.
So we usually don't have them pull on there because it's going to tip back. It's not really made for getting them up. It's made for when they're standing.
Okay.
There. We'll help you underneath. Yeah. Okay. Ready?
Got it.
Let us know when you're ready. Count it off.
Okay.
You want me to do it? Okay. 1, 2, 3.
Ah!
Breathe. Good job. Breathe out. Breathe out. Breathe out. Okay, hands on the walker. Hands on the walker. We got you. Good.
We got you.
You okay? Are you dizzy at all?
Good job.
No. Just stand here for a minute. Don't rush it.
Breathe in through the nose. Slowly out through the mouth.
Good.
Keep doing that.
Oh.
Yeah.
What's up?
Can you pass them out?
No.
What do I look like?
You said I'm about to pass out and just... and then you went pale, you turned pale.
For real?
Yeah, like you was about to die. Like your skin color changed immediately.
Really? You got white
again? White and your lips was like really, really white. I needed both arms because you felt like you collapsed in my arms.
I didn't know what that was. It felt like my chest, like I couldn't breathe at first.
I think you just walked too fast. Like next time you got to take a step, wait a little bit, breathe in and out.
But it's normal though, you know.
I was trying.
It's not normal. It's not unusual, let me just say.
I was trying
from this part, you walk by yourself. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it was touching.
It hurts so bad, and if I like walk all the way that like on my feet, like flat, it hurts. It's like a strikes a nerve. I was trying to get it over with.
And that probably was why you passed out. You rushed it. He was right there about the squat and everything.
I felt it. That's crazy. Hey y'all, don't mind my voice. My voice is gonna be a little scratchy a little bit because they had to put a tube down my throat. The TV cut out and they turned my lights off and the lights are way over there. Obviously, I can't get up, so we're just gonna work with this flashlight and the TV. But as I was saying, y'all, so the last time that I spoke to y'all, I think I was doing my registration or something, and then I couldn't record anything in the back because everything went so fast, like literally. It was like 1, 2, 3,
The only thing that took the longest was waiting on the doctor to get there. But them nurses was not playing. They was getting me going. But yeah, I do have some footage of like me talking to the doctor and stuff like that that I'll include in here. But overall, my pain is a 10 out of 10. It hurts a lot. The surgery was 6 hours. I went in at 8. I came out around 2 something. And then I was still asleep from the anesthesia, so I didn't wake up until like 4 something, and they brought me upstairs because I was admitted. And y'all, my body's been taking me through it. So I'm supposed to be discharged tomorrow, as long as I can walk, because one of the requirements is for me to be able to walk. And I honestly was supposed to do it today. Like, you're supposed to walk a few hours after surgery. When I tell y'all, it feels like hell. Like, I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy. The feeling is crazy. So when I got up to try and walk, I got to the bathroom, which is right here. And as I was walking to the bathroom, I started feeling like chest pains, and then it started feeling like I couldn't breathe. And so by the time I got to the bathroom and I went to go and pull my nightgown up, I felt like the feeling got worse. So I had told the nurse that I was about to pass out. So yeah, everything just went from there. I ended up passing out because my blood pressure dropped really, really low, and I thought the good Lord was calling me. I thought it was my motherfucking time. And then I have like 1, 2, 3, 4 pillows, because it hurts so bad laying here. Like, if I'm me sitting up like this, it hurts, but me laying back, it feels like my back is arched, and it hurts more. So it's like I'm just super, super, super uncomfortable. And then don't even get me started on the pain meds. When I first sorry y'all, my nurse came in, but I had to turn the lights on real fast because I was tired of holding that other phone. But basically, when I first got up here, all they gave me was Tylenol 1000, so basically extra strength Tylenol, 2 extra strength Tylenol. And then around like 5, they gave me 2 oxycodones, but that's not helping. So now they're gonna see if I'm able to get more meds, and they're gonna try and mix them to see, like, to make it stronger, to see if that helps. So that's why I'm waiting for my nurse. But she came in and she added more pillows on my top half of my back, my head, and my legs. But yeah, y'all, I'm in so much pain. But ever since I passed out, I've been fine. I do have food that I got from the food court, and their food is actually really good. Like, it's seasoned and everything. I don't even know what this is. It looks like a jambalaya type of thing, or whatever that's called. It's really good, but it's just spicy. And then I got a burger and some onion rings. Them onion rings is good. I ripped the onion rings earlier. I got some candy, water, and some soda. But yeah, y'all, I'm super sad. Visiting hours is only from 8 to 8. So I'm upset about that, because I hate being alone and going through stuff alone in the hospital. But my nurses are really, really nice. So So I guess that's a good thing, because you know, some people be getting rude nurses. But my nurses have been super nice, very helpful. So yeah. But yeah. Hey, Rat.
Is Miss Martin?
Yeah.
Would you like me to call you?
You can call me.
Your name?
Ciaja.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, thank
Let
you.
Let me tell you. So, the oxygen, you took around 5:45. You can rush to 6.
Okay.
I can give you 10 p.m. one.
Okay.
It's a 10 milligrams. And I have Xenoflax for you. That's a muscle relaxant. So I can give you together.
Okay.
And the only thing is, so you're going to decide. Xenoflax is just twice, it's every 8 hours. So if I give at 10, then the next one will be tomorrow. And
for both the men?
No. For just Xenoflax.
Okay.
For ox, I give you 10, then I can give you 4.
Okay.
AM. And then you want me to bring it together?
Yeah.
That was the question.
Yes.
Then you know, then after in the F4, I can just bring you oxy.
Okay.
And I see if you have Tylenol, so I can buy two.
Okay.
Bring it to you too. And then you know after that, it'll be tomorrow morning, then you can ask the nurse and I can let them know you want Xenoflax and ox together morning.
Okay.
Sounds good?
Yes.
Sounds a plan?
Yeah.
Okay, good. So anything else I can do for you?
No.
Leave the light on? It's up to you. I'll be back.
You could dent it just a little bit more.
Sure. Let me know when it's good. So you stop.
Yeah, that's fine.
All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, they need to do something because this pain is no joke. And that little bit of Tylenol, 1,000 milligram, is not cutting it. I was taking Tylenol before. That's what I first started out with, taking Tylenol. Here we go with the lights. Look who came to see me, guys, for my vlog. And she brought Dunkin' real food because this was BS they gave me. Say hi.
Hi.
She's being mean to y'all.
It took me that long to get
Yeah, she's mad. Right now, I think I'm about to take a nap until my mom and Maji comes. My mom is supposed to be bringing Maji up here to see me. So I think I'm gonna take a nap until they get here. They do live about 55 minutes away. I'm sure it'll be a little bit longer than that because of traffic. So I'm gonna take me a nice little nap, well, another nap, because my nap earlier is interrupted by PT. So I'm gonna take me another nap or whatever. And yeah, I'll show you guys when Maji gets here. I'm super excited to see him. I miss my baby so much. But yeah, y'all, I'm finna catch some Z's and I'll see y'all later on. Guess who came to see me, and they already look, they care more about my food than anything.
What's this?
Ooh. All you been doing since you got here, eating my stuff?
No, I got no hug. No, not only did you hug, you're eating some of her burrito.
Now you're coming over here.
Why?
On my YouTube.
YouTube's not on that. Everyone subscribe and make sure she feels better.
Thank you.
I'll be on YouTube too much. I already know that.
You look just like me,
y'all.
Is it good, Marge?
You just want to see the food, yeah.
Well, I want to see the cafeteria.
This looks like paper.
Can I see the cafeteria?
It's a tortilla.
Can I see the
cafeteria? Like a taco?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is a taco. It's supposed to be a chicken taco.
It is. But it has cheese.
I think it's on me.
Mm-hmm.
chicken
and pepper?
I don't know. I didn't try it.
Hold on, try one.
Wait a minute, come on.
It's okay.
I'm not buying nothing now.
No, I
want to
stay with that.
I said she could have some of this chicken right here.
You want this chicken?
No.
It's good.
It's real good. And what does that mean?
You ate that?
Lips.
No, I'm not giving it to my mommy. No, my
mom doesn't. Mind you, I don't want that.
Why are you spilling stuff?
You don't want drawers. Anything crazy.
How you took your nail off in his way right over here?
It's good.
Thank you. Good. Manji's upset because he doesn't want to leave. Tell him why you're so. Alright, don't cry. Aww. Aww, Sting, come here. Hold on, guys.
Hey, y'all.
So, today is post-op day 3, it's currently September 14th, and the girl is ready for bed. What time is it? It is 7:25-ish, and let me just tell y'all about my day. So, physical therapy whipped my ass today, not even gonna lie. So they came early this morning, I want to say around like 9 or 10 ish, and they tried to get me out the bed. It hurt so freaking bad. But when they went to go lift me, once again I went to go pass out because my blood pressure dropped, so they laid me back down, and then they came back around between 1 and 2, and they tried again. And at that point, they had given me fluids and stuff, so I was able to get up, obviously with the help of the nurses. And they had me go from the bed to the walker, from the walker to the chair, and then they made me sit in the chair for a while. I got my drain pulled out today, well, taken out. Today's Thursday, hopefully Friday, they're saying Friday or Saturday I get discharged. My doctor isn't recommending rehab because of my age, but physical therapy and OT were recommending it. So I really don't know what's gonna happen. But yeah, but right now I'm about to try to get some sleep. I haven't really been able to sleep all day because every chance I got, there was a nurse or a doctor coming in, checking, doing my vitals, or having me lift my legs, doing something that's gonna hurt. So I can feel the pain coming on strong, so usually I'm able to watch something to take my mind off of it, and then eventually helps me doze off. So I'm hoping to do just that until it's time for my next pain meds and muscle relaxer. So yeah, you guys, this will complete day 3, hopefully day 3 post-op in the hospital. Hopefully I only have 1 to 2 more days here, because I wasn't even really supposed to be here this long. But you know, things happen. Everybody's body is different. Everyone's pain tolerance, pain level is different as well. So this is just me, and yeah. So I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Hey guys, this is post-op day 4 for me. Still in the hospital. Whew. As you can tell, I'm in a little bit of pain. I'm super uncomfortable because they have me sitting up in this damn chair. But let me just tell y'all a little bit about my day so far. So earlier, I had breakfast. I ate 2 French toasts. and a slice of bacon. Then somewhere between like, I want to say 11 and 12, I had PT. And for PT, they wanted me to walk. Well, not walk. They wheeled me in this chair to the steps, and they wanted me to just keep trying to go up and down the steps. So because I have like 15 to 20 steps at home, I have to do at least 8 of their 2 steps here. So basically to be determined as safe enough to go home, if that makes sense. I don't know. But I was only able to do 6. So I did 3 sets of 2 and I passed out. So one of the problems I've been having, I can't remember if I mentioned it before, is that my blood pressure keeps dropping. So whenever they do give me up for physical therapy, I'm passing out like cold, like going out. Or I'm feeling lightheaded or dizzy. And so whenever I do that, it pushes me back from going home. So today is Saturday and I'm supposed to be going home, but now it got pushed back a day because of me fainting or passing out, whatever. So I am really, really upset about that because I was looking forward to going home. No, I'm not able to walk and scoot up and stuff like that, but I will be getting in-home physical therapy once I do go home, so I don't have to learn everything here in the hospital in order to leave. I just have to be determined safe enough to go home. So anyways, with that being said, right now I'm still trying to eat lunch. I've been super, super tired because my blood pressure is still dropping. I don't know why, but I just been sleeping on and off, on and off. But right now I'm trying to eat. I have a salad here. I have a chicken Caesar salad with a turkey sandwich, some chips. They sent me a Pepsi and an Ensure. So that's what I'm trying to eat now. And then hopefully my sister, she's supposed to be bringing Samaj up here. So I'm hoping to be able to see him. But y'all, I'm really upset. I'm so upset. I just want to go home.
Hey!
Bad Butt is leaving, y'all. He came up in here and he showed his butt, didn't you?
No.
Ain't it? You won't even listen in. Put this back up there. Give me a hug. Love you.
Love you.
He has a game tomorrow, y'all. Everybody wish him luck in his game. Come on, come say bye, because you're fiending to be in the video, too. Hey, don't be mean. Maji, stop.
Hi, y'all.
No, you're saying bye.
Oh, bye.
And look, my CNN.
That's
my caregiver.
Mm-hmm.
Don't make me laugh.
The little big genie.
Hey, stop covering her. That's
the little
mean.
Big booty genie.
Y'all see how? Come on, why do you keep saying that? Yeah.
They don't teach you that.
No, they did not. You learned that from Maji?
No, they didn't tell
her
she
that's
did.
That's what she called on
Tina. Yeah,
baby. Mm. Well, don't say that. You don't know what it means. Why are you whining and stuff? These kids be wilding, y'all, but they're out. Say bye.
Hey guys, today is Monday, September 18th, and girl is finally going home.
Let me see this sheet. They don't have it downstairs, so I'm thinking it's at the one next room. Is that okay for you to pick that up there?
Yeah.
Can you call them just to make sure? I just want to make sure that they have it before you go, because I don't want you to run into any problems. So call them, let me know, make sure they have it, and then I put in for transportation to come up, and I'll come take your ID out.
Okay. So, girl, I finally go home. I'm super excited. Y'all, I couldn't wait for this day. It's just so much. I'll probably explain to y'all by the time I get home.
But let me do what I gotta do so I can get up out of here.